I'm Jeff Kravitz, and I think that some people in the area may have known that I've been involved in defending the rights of the Occupy movement in Sacramento, which is a good example, the way the government reacted to it, of the way that this government in Sacramento and throughout the United States wastes taxpayer money on unnecessary prosecutions. I'd have to congratulate Jan Scully that she so far did not go along with that prosecution. So right now in this county we are faced with all sorts of dilemmas, and we are faced with part of the problem is that we have a leadership that is essentially identical year after year after year after year. If you look back for the last few elections, many of the Board of Supervisors have been re-elected because they weren't even challenged. And yet it's local government that has the most direct effect on people's everyday lives. Right now, in this county and in this state and in this whole country, we need creative leadership to work directly with the people of this county, with the small business owners throughout the 3rd District, where you see commercial property after commercial property that is shut down, that can't be rented out, and we have a county board of supervisors that is constantly interested in new developments. Each one of these new developments is cannibalizing the ability of the people who already own property to go forward and make profit off of their businesses. Nothing wrong with profit, nothing wrong with economic growth, but that growth has to be channeled towards the people in this community who are living here. Instead, we have a government that seems to be obsessed with large developers, large corporations, which have absolutely nothing to do with this county. A prime example of it, which is going on right now, it affects both the county and the city, is the idea of selling off the parking lots in the city. One of those parking lots they want to sell off is right there. It's owned by the county. They want the county to give that parking lot to the city so the city can sell it off as part of their plan of taking money away from the taxpayers, which is what would happen because all of parking revenue goes into the general fund, and using it to finance a giant white elephant that they're calling an arena downtown. All of this is because local government is not thinking about the needs of the people in this locality. That's what we're going to change. We want to bring the people into the county. As Gary just said, one of the ideas we're proposing is that the Board of Supervisors meet at night, make the job like it is in many other counties and so forth, essentially a part-time job. The salaries would be less, but the meetings would be more open. There would be more community involvement. Just this week, the Board of Supervisors has apparently voted to spend $1 million in funds that they're going to receive, money that could go to the general fund, to make the council chambers nicer. The council chambers are usually empty. People don't even know what's going on at the votes that are happening there, and they're going to spend more money on that. We have to look into all of these issues, and every decision has to be made as to how it affects the vast majority of people who are living in this county. When we spend money in this county, when the government spends money on development and so forth, it's much better, in my opinion, to give $100,000 grants to 100 people rather than spending $10 million on one project, which is what goes on perpetually in the Sacramento region in this mad race to make us some kind of major urban center like Los Angeles or San Francisco. That's not going to happen. What we need is a local government that understands what this community is all about, hears public services, and also all programs towards developing the small business infrastructure of this county. And that's what we're going to do when we are elected this year. Thanks.